So what we're going to do now is very similar to what we did with the keyword. We're going to use our plain text here, and if our plain text goes down here, so this is a secret message, we want to convert this, the T, into the 5 binary bits, or bits, and then the H there, and the I, and so on. So let's put our plain text in there just to test it. Let's select and merge and center these at the top and type in plain text. Now let's put a grid around it, and we want to use a multiple of 8. So let's go all the way up to the 25th cell here. Excuse me. So the 25th is that one just there. And let's put a grid around all of those. So what we're going to do is exactly the same as we did here. We click in cell Q2, and we insert function, and it's a VLOOKUP. And because it was the last one I used, it's still there. Press OK. And the lookup value is the T here in cell P2. The table array is binary, just like it was before. And the column index is, well, this is the second column of the binary table, so it's 2. And finally, you put false in there. And let's drag those over. And now we need to change this, because this is P2 and 2. This one should be P2 and false, but it's not. So, sorry, P2 and 3. So we change that to a P, and that to a 3. Next one, change that to a P, and that to a 4. And then that to a P, and that to a 5, and that to a P, and that to a 6. So we've got P22, P23, P24, P25, and P26. Select all of those, and then drag them down. So now we've done that, we get to do the converting bit. And the converting uses something called exclusive OR. We're going to convert into 5 binary bits rather here. So let's make those smaller, and let's put a grid around all of those. So this first one here is going to be this one compared with this one. And if they're the same, then it's going to be a 0, but if they're different, it's going to be a 1. So 0 and 1, that'll be a 1. This one compares this and this. So if they're the same, it's a 0, but they're not, so it's going to be a 1. Then we compare this one and this one. 1 and 0, they're different, so that's a 1. And then we compare 1 and 1. Well, they're the same, so that's a 0. And this one and 1 is the same, so that's a 0. And then this one is the result of this compared with this, and then all the way down. And when we get to the end of our keyword, we compare this one, we go back to the start, so that compares with that, and that compares with that, and then we'll do that once more, and that will be the end of our ciphertext. So let's delete those, because we want to do this by hand, automatically rather. What we say is, well, equals if. So up here in cell V2 you type equals if, and then we put a bracket in there, and it says our logical test. And the logical test is, does this one equal this one? So does J2 equal Q2? And if the answer is true, we put a comma, and if they are equal to each other, we want to see a 0. But if they're false, so another comma, 1. And you close the bracket, and so this whole thing says, if J2 was equal to Q2, the answer is 0, else it's 1. Press enter, and we get the answer 1, like we expected, because they're different. Now, if we pull that across, that should work. So we have this one here, does K2 equal R2? And yes, it does. And so, or rather it doesn't, so it's 1, Then does 1 equal 0? No, so it's 1, but these two are the same, so they're both 0. So now put all of that down, all the way down to here. And now what we want to do is to go back up to the start. So we want to say for this one, well, equals if this one equals that one now, then comma 0, else comma 1. Let's pull them over. And then 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, which is the length of our keyword. And the last one here equals if this one here is equal to this one here, then it's a 0, else it's a 1. Pull them over. Do that again. Pull them over and then pull them down. And let's just test this. So let's change this one to a Q, a name change. Let's change that one to a an R. That one changes. Let's change this one to a D. Yeah. So without doing any proper vigorous testing, we can see that they definitely update. So let's change these back to what they are. This is a secret message. And now what we want to do is let's save that, because we don't want to lose any more work. We want to convert this binary number into the decimal number. And this is a lot easier than it sounds, because we know that this one is the number of ones, this one is the number of twos, fours, eights, and sixteens. So in this cell, we say that this binary number is equal to this many ones, so that times one, plus that times two, plus that one times four, plus that one times eight, plus that one times 16. So 11100 is 28. Let's just double check that down here. 28, 11100. So with that, put it all the way down. And this is our decimal representation of all of these numbers. The last thing we want to do is to convert these numbers back into their characters. So it's another vertical lookup here. Click in cell AC2. And let's insert a VLOOKUP. And the lookup is this number here. The table array, we called it cars or chars. The column index is, well, it's going to be column 2. And the range lookup here is false. Do that. Let's pull it all the way down. And let's tidy this up. So let's put a grid around all of these. Let's merge and center those, and let's call that our ciphertext. So, we've got, with this password, this is a secret message, gets encrypted as 2H04A42, and so on. Let's check that this works. So, what we're going to do inside our plain text is put in what the ciphertext was. So, this is going to be a 2. This is an H, I think that's a 0, yep, then an A, 4, 2, R, R, L, C, D, W, F, C, V, R, 3, A, U, W, M, U, L, Z. And what we have is this is a secret message, which works perfectly. So let's delete that and let's put in another message. So, well done if this works. And now we can see what happens when we change the password. So let's put in another password up here. Let's put in year. because it can't fit in year 7. And you see we have a completely different ciphertext here. And the reason this becomes so difficult to crack, like I said earlier, is that two letters, so two L's, are encrypted as two different characters. So let's save that before we do anything else. We don't want to ruin this. And let's do a bit of tidying up. And the first thing we want to do is to hide the information that we're not interested in. So all of this, select all of that, right click and hide it, because that doesn't matter. Select all of this, right click and hide, and select all of this, right click and hide, and all of this, and right click and hide. And now what we've got, let's make these a little bigger so we can see them all, is we have our keywords, our plain text, and our ciphertext. And we can use this to encrypt and decrypt very hard to crack codes. Safety work, and well done.